Hey, what's up? You're back at the Trailer Project. I'm Alexander Miller, writer for Battleship Retention and Film Inquiry. After a little bit of a hiatus, the Trailer Project is back in action at a new venue. But trust me, dear subscribers, the MO remains the same. We're going to be checking out trailers for awesome movies, talking about them, and having fun along the way. So, having said that, today's film's really interesting because it's got something to do with Netflix. Now, Netflix has developed a kind of a compelling reputation over the past few years, not just because of their streaming platform, but because they are also known to periodically cut a blank check to a distinctive filmmaker in order for them to make their whatever passion project. It worked great for Scorsese with The Irishman, it worked great for Noah Baumbach's Marriage Story, and it also worked for Alfonso Caurón with Roma. A lot of people love that movie. I am not one of them. I think it's good, but that's another conversation. So that made the appeal and the case for Wasp Network, today's film, all the more interesting. Olivier Assayas is returning to the world of, globe-trotting espionage and counterintelligence. He has a cast of beautiful people, some of whom he's worked with before, ergo Edgar Ramirez. You got Penelope Cruz, Juan Garcia Bernal. What could possibly go wrong? Well, I don't think anything went wrong. I love this movie. It's on my top 10 of 2020, eagerly awaited its release, and happy to say I think it was a compelling, complex slice of revisionist espionage stuff. However, I was kind of in the minority on that one. And after a few years, the opinion largely seems to have stayed the same. Some people like it, a lot of people don't. Now, personally speaking, Olivier Assayas is one of my favorite filmmakers. Whether it's Carlos, Cold Water, Personal Shopper, Clowns of Sils Maria, I just gobble them all up. He's always doing interesting work, and I'm always eager to see what he's getting into. So without further ado, let's check out the trailer for Wasp Network. Buzz buzz. Here we go with Wasp Network. Thank you, Netflix. Initially, when I read some of the more negative reviews, I was actually kind of relieved and a little more excited. Not that I was being a contrarian, but that was the same case with Personal Shopper, Clouds of Sils Maria, and even Carlos. A lot of people didn't really know what to make of it. And that's kind of what you want in an artist, someone that's challenging your sensibilities and challenging your tastes and preferences. Necesitamos piloto como tú. There you go, you got some slick hand-to-hand shit, hide in plain sight. See, you got the true story, you got the star-studded cast of beautiful people. With all that, you think this would be a cinch. I always feel like Olivier Assayas' movies are films you interact with. You can't really passively watch any of them. And here, it feels like he's telling us that if you work in covert ops or counterintelligence, is that it's really fucking hard.
They have these really raw, these really human, intimate moments. For instance, like this scene where she sees that her house has been tagged with spray paint.
It's funny because you can tell this trailer, they're trying to hype up the action, give it a little boost of adrenaline. It really doesn't need it.
You don't know everything about me.
It's important que usted sepa la verdad. She has this great line, being a traitor's wife is not an easy job. I feel like if you want to know what covert espionage looks like, this is about as close as we're going to get. Maybe this in the works of Jean Le Carre. It's ironic because you have Assayas kind of returning to Carlos territory. You got Edgar Ramirez, you've got international intrigue. Granted, going into the film, I had never heard of the Wasp Network. I didn't even know it existed. And that's why we need art. That's why we need artists, and that's why we need people like Olivier Assayas. They bring us material that we don't know about, and they present it to us in a compelling way that allows us to interact with, interpret, and think about for long afterwards. Anyhow, this has been Alex. Thanks for watching. Check out some other stuff, and we'll see you around.